Hello children, so today early in the morning when you have opened your mobile, you have been seen that your teachers have been uploaded different worksheet, assignments, homework in your group and you are busy solving this. To complete your task of the day, you use different resources. You are watching the videos on the YouTube uploaded by the teachers. You are going through the book reading. So the different methods you are using to complete your task, that means you are moving to the process of development to complete the task day by day. Yes, so today the name of our chapter is Resource and Development of Class 10, Lesson 1, Geography. In this lecture, we are going to cover the types of resources, classification of resources, Agenda 21, sustainable development, resource planning and the conservation of resource. Let's begin with resource. What is resource? What do you mean by term resource? Resource means everything in our environment that can be used to satisfy our needs, which is technically accessible, economically feasible and culturally acceptable, is termed as resource. Now let's see the classification of the resources. Resources are of three types, that is natural, human and human-made resource. So let's start with the classification of the natural resources. On the basis of origin, it is of two types, biotic and abiotic. The living beings are the biotic resource, human beings, plants and animals. The abiotic are the non-living beings like rocks, minerals, metals, sun, wind energy, etc. are the abiotic resource. On the basis of exhaustibility, it is of two types, renewable and non-renewable resources. The resources which can be renewed or reproduced is known as renewable resource. For example, wind energy, solar energy, forests, etc. The non-renewable resources are the resources that form through a long period of time or they cannot be regenerated. For example, the minerals, the metals and the fossil fuels, they cannot be generated because it takes thousands and millions of years to form again. On the basis of energy, on the basis of ownership, individual resource. These resources are owned privately, for example, well, the farmland, the pasture land, etc. Community resource. These resources are owned by the community, for example, the burial ground, the pond of the village, the public park, etc. The national resource. These resources are the property of the nation, for example, the coal mines, the territorial sea region, canals, etc. The next one is the international resources. These resources are owned and regulated by the international institution. Example, the sea is open for the peaceful navigation, the sky is open for the movement of the flight. On the basis of the status of development, the resources are of following type. The first one is the potential development. These resources are found in abundance, but we have not yet been developed to utilize this resource. The techniques have not been developed to use this resource properly. For example, solar and wind energy in Gujarat and Rajasthan. The second one is developed resources. These resources has been used and utilized. Example, coal and petroleum. The another one is the stock. The resources have the potential to satisfy the human need, but the technical know-how to utilize this resource have not been developed is known as the stock. Let me give you the example of water. Water has the combination of oxygen and hydrogen. but still we don't know the technology to use the hydrogen and oxygen from it. So this is the stock for us. The next one is the reserve. They are the specific stock for which the appropriate technological know-how is available, but the exploitation is not started yet. Example, the river water. The river water is a reserve until and unless it is utilized to generate the hydel power. Forest is a reserve and until and unless it is not exploited properly. Sustainable development means the present development should take place without damaging the environment, and there should be the sufficient stock for the need of the future generation. For this, the proper resource planning is needed. So the concept of sustainable development was first formulated in June 1992 at the first United Nations conference held in Rio de Janeiro at Brazil. This summit supported the global forest principle and adopted the Agenda 21. What are the objectives of Agenda 21? Its objectives are: the development should take place, it should eliminate the poverty, hunger, sickness, illiteracy, and reduce the deterioration of environment. So for achieving all this objective, we need the proper resource planning. What is resource planning? Resource planning means identification and quantification of available resource along with their development. Resource planning should match with the goal of national development. In India, there are vast resources, but the distribution of the resource are uneven. For example, Arunachal Pradesh has the abundant water resource, but they lack in the infrastructure development. Let me give you the another example. In Rajasthan, we have the sufficient resource of solar and wind energy, but lack of water resource. Irrational consumption and overutilization of resources may lead to socio-economic and environmental problem. So to overcome this problem, there is a need to conserve the environment. For this, Gandhiji has raised his voice and he was very much concerned about the resource. He told that there is enough for everybody's need, but not for anybody's greed. He was against the mass production. So in this lecture, we have seen what is resource, the classification of the resource, Agenda 21, sustainable development, and the need to conserve the resource. In the next lecture, we will know about the land resources. So go to the lecture and classify the types of resources.